Welcome back to joanne.com. I'm your host Mikey of the Crochet Crowd. We are going for week number three. Yes, clue number three as we go in our mystery adventure together. This is the Bernat Blanket Stitch Along, where we're taking just an idea and going in a mystery path to get to a final afghan. We're on clue number three, so we're now going to be 75% done after the end of today's tutorial. So of course, if you're not ready for today's tutorial and you missed the clues, I won't tell anybody. You can just scroll back and get the patterns in order to get week one and week two completed so that you can join me right back here as we do week number three together. Week number three, don't tell anybody, but you can scroll to the end of this video if you really like to see what you're going to be up to today. But of course, if you like to live dangerously, you can just stay right here and hook your way through it and be pleasantly surprised in the end. This is going in a completely different path. So just between us friends, don't tell anybody, it's just our secret. No, seriously, don't tell anybody. Week number three has more work involved than the rest of the other weeks, but week number four is just a polishing off of just finishing it off. It's like the icing on the cake. That'll be week number four. So put in your time this week, because next week we're gonna finish it off and you are gonna be totally amazed. So without further ado, let's head down to the studio right now and let's get started. In clue number three, this is what we have done so far. So we have clue number one, which is a circle, and clue number two, we converted the circle into a square. So we've been working in a continuous round to make the entire circle, so we've never had to turn our work and flip it to the other side. Even when doing this square, we continue to do a continuous revolution. So this whole thing that we're looking at right now, clue one and two, we've been working with the right side of the project only, but now the equation's gonna change as we move into clue number three. So in clue number three, before we even get started on this particular project, we need to flip this over and work starting on the wrong side. So just pretend this was a double-sided sheet of paper, and we need to flip the good side over and start crocheting. And if you can just barely see it here, you'll start crocheting on the back side and working your way across like so. And so you'll go back and forth. And when you go then to do the other side of the project, so we're gonna do the top edge first and then the bottom edge second. And then when you do the bottom edge, you're just gonna turn it around, keeping this so that the front side is facing down, okay? So this is still the wrong side. You're gonna start over here like so and work your way across. So you just have to be paying attention to what is the right side and the wrong side, and this matters for clue number three. So what we're going to be doing for clue number three is that we're gonna start on the top edge and work our way up. So let me just draw on this. And so we're just gonna work our way up and create an extension of the stitches for out for a certain length, just like this. You're then going to move to the bottom and you're going to then create the same thing on the bottom. So you're gonna end up with the top edge and the bottom edge each having something extra. And then what we're going to do from that point is that we're gonna start up on the edge and we're gonna work our way around this, building it up so then we continue the color. So by the time if you see the end result at the end of this video, you'll see exactly what we're looking for. So let's continue, and I wanna show you the diagrams and what we're gonna be doing today. So here's a cross section of what's gonna happen as we build out. So look at this diagram like it's two parts to this particular section, and it really is two parts. So you have rows 1 through 5. So you're going to start up on the top edge of your square and you're gonna just go back and forth from 1 to 5. Once you have that done, you're gonna repeat rows 2 through 5 once more so that you'll end up with kind of like almost a double section of what you're seeing. It'll only be 9 rows complete. You have to then finish that off and fasten off for the top edge, but for the bottom edge, you have to do exactly as shown here and then just stay fastened on. Don't fasten off at the end of yet. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna turn the project around and then we're gonna start working on this as a complete rotation. So this, any part of the clue number three is not really a big deal by any stretch. It's just a matter of going step by step. So this is my other sheet. So think about this as being part two of clue number two. So once we get our top edge and our bottom edge all done, we're gonna then go in a complete revolution by choosing. So the very last one, the bottom edge, we're not gonna fasten off. We're simply gonna turn our work and then we're gonna be back on the right side of the project. So we're gonna be back on the front side as we do this whole revolution. So these ones here that have been going back and forth, we're turning our work each time, but these ones here work back in a continuous revolution as you go around and around. So why is there holes in space missing over here? Well, the designer is showing you exactly how the corners are operating over here, so you can assume that what's happening here is the same as over here, and the edge down below and the edge down on this side. So just because it's missing here doesn't mean you don't do it, it's just showing you what you need to look for. So if you're not sure what to do here, just look back, and the only thing that's really different is that you don't have to do slip stitching and there's no building up chains when you do a regular corner. The other thing that you need to watch for is right down the side edge. So what we're going to do is in round number one, we're gonna circle the entire afghan with single crochets. So let's just follow it here with the fuchsia color, and we're gonna come across. So down here you'll notice that you're going into the side of the stitches. Your goal is to make sure that you get 12 single crochets equally spaced from this one section down until you hit that middle square of your piece that you're working with. So you have to equally space 12 and then just go along the square and single crochet into each until you hit the other one. So when you hit the other one, just visualize it like you're coming down and the square is over here somewhere, and then you have to equally space it before you hit an edge. You single crochet across, turn your corner, and then equally space another 12 up here, go across your square, and you'll come back up the other side just like so, and you'll equally space 12 just like that. So it becomes really quite easy to do, and really if anything that could be the hardest round, I don't know. It's really no big deal. Your secret is just to make sure that you end up with 12, because what happens beyond this point matters on that in order to be 12. So as we start to do the crochet nail element 2, number 3, is that this sheet of paper doesn't tell you that this is the right side or the wrong side. That's in the written instructions. So what I want you to do is that we have to make sure that we start this on the wrong side. So what I did for myself is that the first time I ever did this is that I had this laying on my on me as I was crocheting, and what I did is that in order to crochet in the wrong side, I flipped this thing over, and then basically if you flip this over and you flip this up to crochet, guess what? You're on the right side still, and that's where I went wrong. So what I have to do is that I have to look at it just like so. So the right side is facing up to me, and now I'm gonna flip up the edge and crochet myself along this edge, which then puts me onto the wrong side, which is exactly where I need to be. So you just gotta watch for that the very first time. Okay, so let's start row number one. We're only gonna do row number one once, and then when we go to do repeat pattern will be rows 2 through 5, so just be aware of that. So this is going to go across the edge, which is the white that you see here, and so row number one will be working way across that, and we just have to be very paying attention to that. So we're just gonna single crochet, chain one, skip one, single crochet in the next, chain one, skip one, single crochet in the next, and we're gonna do that all the way across. Let's begin. You can refer to this chart as it is available through this pattern if you wish, and we're gonna go through 1 through 5 together right now. So what we want to do is that we need to begin in the third one from the edge. So because I've been crocheting in this direction, I normally crochet in that direction, the third one is from the square or from the corner. So there's 4 stitches in the corner, so it's the third one in because I'm crocheting this way. So if you're left-handed you will see it from a different perspective than what you're seeing here, but it's still the same one. The other thing that you could look at too is that you can see that this is the end one of the 4, and this is the second one over. You can look for the second, but technically in technical words it's the third one over. I'm just going to create just a loop here, slip knot, and I'm gonna insert my hook in, and I'm gonna go into the third one like so, and I'm just gonna join it just like this, and I'm going to then chain up one and single crochet into the same one, and that'll begin as I go across. So the next one, just like it showed in the diagram, is chain one. You're going to skip one and you're going to single crochet into the next. What I like to do is put this straggler down on top of the line and then get that stuck underneath so it gets really quite trapped quite nicely, and therefore you can bury it. So it's chain one, skip one, go into the next. Chain one, skip one, go into the next. Okay, so when I'm looking in the distance I should be looking at the right side, okay, because technically I'm crocheting on this side here, which is the wrong side. Okay, so just do that all the way across. So chain one, skip one, single crochet in the next. I'll meet you on the other side of this corner, or on the next corner, and then I'll show you how to turn your work. So I've come up all the way across and I'm chaining one And the last one, you skip one, and the last one should be in the third one, or sorry, should be in the second one on this side. Okay, so remember what I said is that you have to count the corners as if you're going in the direction that you're crocheting. So it's actually the second one on this side. You can look at it from that perspective, or if you are gonna look at it from the side, then it's the third one up. Either way, it's still the same stitch. So that's how it would look like then for row number one. So you've gone all the way across like so, and now let's turn our work and go for row number two. So let's turn our work, and I don't turn everything over, I just kinda, cause I'm gonna have to turn it back anyway. So I just turn it over just enough so I can access this side. And I'm just going to start off row number two. We're gonna chain up one, single crochet in the first single crochet, and single crochet in the chain one space. So everything is gonna get a single crochet, whether it's a single crochet or a chain one space. Just one each, going all the way down for row number two. I'll meet you at the end of the row. As I come up across, and I'm working across on row number one, I'm actually on row number two, but I'm working across on here in row number one. And what I want to do is that strand that we went and buried over top of, you can see it. So what I wanna do in this round here is that, or this row, is that I wanna make sure that I go around that as well in order to trap that into position so it gets nice and stuck into the stitches. And therefore you'll never have to see it come out of your work. Okay, so just when you get to the end, you'll run into that strand and just make sure that you capture it underneath, and therefore that also then pulls it up and creates that division line that you see right there quite nicely. So it's a great trick without having to pull out a darning needle. So go all the way to the edge, and here's the last one right here, and that is row number two. And let's move along to row number three. So let's turn our work and go for row number three. So coming back to what we were at before. Row number three, we're going to do very similar to what we did in row number one, if not the same, is that you chain one, one single crochet into the first one, and then chain one and skip one, one single crochet into the next. Chain one, skip one, one single crochet into the next. Please do that all the way down the row. So I'm coming up all the way to the edge, okay, chain one, skip one, and look, the last stitch is the last one, so it's good. So I know that I'm on track and on key with row number three. Let's turn our work and go for row number four next. Row number four, we're gonna start doing some puff stitching, and I'll show you how to do that next. So we're gonna create some beautiful detail, and it's called the puff stitch, and this is row number four. So we're gonna have to come back to and do row number four one more time when we do the repeat patterns two through five. So we're going to chain up two, just like so, and we are going to come into the spaces of the chain one that you see all along here, and those are all gonna be puff stitches. To do a puff stitch, you're gonna wrap the hook and going into the chain one space, pull through. Give yourself a bit of slack, you need a little bit, and then wrap the hook going in to the same space, pull through, again, give it a bit of slack, and then wrap it one more time, going into the same space and pull through. You have all this luxury on your hook, all this yarn. You are needing to now yarn over and pull through all of that. All of that, just wiggle your way through it, and being a little bit easy and casual with that instead of being tight will allow that. You're then going to chain one. So that's a puff stitch. So after you've done chain one, you're gonna puff into the next. So you're gonna wrap into the chain one space, pull through, give yourself a bit of slack, pull through, yarn over, going in, pull through. So do that total three times, and then yarn over and pull through all of that. You just have to take your time. You will get used to doing this puff stitching just like that. It's all through now, and then chain one. So I'm gonna do it one more time. So in, okay, so that was one, two, and three. Okay, and now pull through all of that and chain one. Okay, so continue to do puff stitches in the chain one spaces all the way across. So I'm coming up close to the end, and I'm puffing all the way down, making sure I'm chaining one in between the puffs, and I've gotten used to doing the puffs by the time I've gotten to this level. I've already done this once before, so it was no stranger to me, but it's one of those techniques where you do have to get used to it each and every time you do it. So I'm gonna puff, and I got one more chain one space left, and I'm gonna puff into that one. And then the very final stitch on this, you're gonna, you're not gonna chain one up to the end of this. You were just simply going to half double crochet into the final single crochet, like so. Okay, so the puff will be resting right up there. Okay, so that's how you complete row number 4. Let's move up for round number 5, row number 5. So let's start up row number 5. So we're gonna do exactly what we did in row number 3, where we're gonna start skipping spaces again. So this time how we do it on this side is that we're gonna chain up 1 and 1 single crochet into the top of the half double crochet, chain 1, and then you're gonna go in between the 2 puffs, just right into the space, and you're gonna single crochet. Chain 1, divide and go in between the next 2 puffs, like so. Chain 1, go in between the next 2 puffs. You get that? Isn't that easy? So just continue to go all the way across for row number 4. So chain 1, single crochet between the puffs, chain 1, single crochet between the puffs. I'll see you on the other side. So I'm coming up close to the end of row number 5. Don't forget chain 1 and then single crochet into the top of the half double crochet. So we have to jump over that last puff to make sure that we keep our pattern consistent. So there is rows 1 through 5. Now we need to repeat rows 2 through 5 one more time before we can just fasten this off. This is the top edge. You're going to repeat exactly what you're seeing here for the bottom edge as well, but at the bottom edge you do not fasten off at the end, and then we'll carry on from that point. So let's repeat rows 2 through 5 one more time. So let's turn our work and go for row number 2. So we go back to the beginning again. So let's turn our work, and we're gonna start on row number 2. So when we had to do this before, we were on row number 1, which we attached to this piece, but we don't need to worry about that here because we're doing a repeat pattern of 2 through 5. So we skip row number 1. So in number 2, if you remember, we're gonna chain up 1 and you're gonna single crochet into the first one, and you're gonna single crochet into the next chain 1 space, and single crochet in the next single crochet, and single crochet in the next chain 1 space. So everything across here, the single crochets and the chain 1, will each get a single crochet, and please do that all the way across for row number 2, and this is the repeat. So I'm coming up to the end of row number 2. This is the repeat going into the final chain 1 space, and then single crochet into the final single crochet. So let's simply turn our work again, and let's go for row number 3. So in row number 3, if you remember, is that we are going to chain 1, single crochet into the first one, just like that, chain 1, skip 1, and single crochet into the next, and you're gonna do that all the way across. So chain 1, skip 1, single crochet into the next. Please do that all the way across for row number 3. So I'm completing row number 3, chain 1, and single crochet finally into the last one, just like that. So let's turn our work and go for row number 4. So row number 4, this is a repeat, so we're gonna do the puff stitching once again. Chain up 2, and you're going to go to the first chain 1 space, and you're gonna begin to puff. So make sure you take your time doing the puff stitching, giving yourself some extra slack so you don't be too tight, and you're gonna puff, pull it through everything, chain 1, and then go to the next chain 1 space and puff again. And you're gonna continue like you did before, and that was the repeat of row number 4. Please do that all the way across. So I'm coming up to the conclusion of the repeat of number 4, and I'm puffing into the last chain 1 space. Do you remember what we did before? Okay, you don't chain 1, you just simply in the last single crochet, you're going to half double crochet. So that puff that lines up directly with the outside, just like this. We're gonna turn our work and go for the final row number, repeat number 5, and then this side is done, and this is the top edge, and then we're gonna move it completely to the opposite, which will be the bottom edge. So let's turn our work, which I've already done, and go for the final of row number 5. So final of row number 5, we're gonna chain up 1, 1 single crochet into the top of the half double crochet, chain 1. You're gonna come in between the next 2 puffs, just stick hook in there, single crochet, chain 1, and go in between the next 2 puffs. So this is row number 5. Now because this is the top edge, what I want you to do is that you're going to fasten off. Okay, you're gonna do that completely, and what you need to do then after that is that you need to come back and you need to do the bottom edge. So go completely opposite across and repeat these steps one more time, but at the end of that do not fasten off, and that's so important because you want to make sure you're keeping your pattern consistent. It will look different if you're not starting on the right side of the, or if you're not starting properly for the next set of clues. So please continue to do this all the way across. So chain 1, single crochet between the puffs. So as I finish Row number 5, in the distance, this is the right side of the project. It's facing up, and see how I'm just crocheting along here? I'm actually crocheting on the wrong side right now. That totally makes a difference on the next set of clues when we get to that point, but this is the ending of the top side for me. And then what I need you to do is that I need you to go to the bottom side and repeat exactly what you did. But remember, you gotta look for that wrong side to be your starting point, because if you don't, it will look slightly different from each other if you start on the wrong section. So once I got my last space here, chain one, and then single crochet into the final top of the chain two that you started with there. So that's it for that. That's rows 1 through 5 and then 2 through 5, and this is top edge, so I'm gonna fasten off at this moment. Just as a recap to fasten off, I'm just pulling the loop through, and now because I'm going to be extending around this edge in the future, is that I can just weave this in and out, in and out, and the next time I go around this, I can trap it underneath the stitches in order to make it work. So that's how you're gonna do that. So let's move along to the bottom edge and let's get that done. I'm not gonna film that separately because it's exactly the same steps as you're doing right now, but I will help you get started because I gotta do it myself. So here's the wrong side that I was just working on. So in the distance, it's the right side that's facing up, but then I just flip the edge and I'm just crocheting along. So because I know this is to be accurate to be the wrong side, all I'm just gonna do now is just flip this around 180 degrees and I'm gonna do the bottom edge. And so I'm still looking at the right side up and this edge is now flipped up for me, okay? And I can see that this is the wrong side that I'm looking at right here. So I'm going to start off in this corner here in order to begin. I'm gonna help you get started and then I'm gonna leave the rest for you because you can just follow what I did on the other side. So let's get started. We're gonna do row number 1, one more time, all 1 through 5 and then 2 through 5. So I'm just gonna help you get started. So remember in the corner, it was the third one, so we crochet in this direction here. So there is 4 stitches in the corner, so it's the third one in, and if you're confused, just look for it and it's the second one in. So just 1, 2, 3, there we go. Okay, so I'm gonna just join it. I'm gonna leave the straggler down on top like I did before, and I'm gonna join and chain one and single crochet into the same stitch. Then chain one, skip 1 stitch, leave this straggler down on top and go right over top of it and trap it underneath because we'll deal with that again like I showed you. And chain one, skip one, single crochet in the next. So chain one, skip one, and single crochet in the next and going right over top of that straggler. So please do this now, and I've now got you started, so you can just scroll back in this video to start and do the repeat pattern, and it's exactly what you learned how to do up here. So the key is to make sure that you start on the wrong side, so the right side should be facing up, your lip will be like this, and then you can just safely go like that, just back and forth. And I will see you at the end of this, and make sure you do not fasten off. That's one thing that you cannot do. And I'll see you back here when that's done. When I last left you, we were starting the bottom edge, and now I've worked my way out. So now I have the bottom edge done, and I have the top edge done, and now I'm ready to go. So right now, I'm currently looking at the wrong side of the project, and when I look at the middle here, I can see that it's the wrong side for sure. And what I can do now is that I need to turn my work so that we are then going to work on the right side. So the remainder of this afghan, we're gonna be back on the right side like we were in the very middle when we were working on all of this stuff and into the square. We were working on the right side the whole time. So the remainder of the project will be doing that as well. So just staying on the right side. So let's pull out our chart and see where we are, and then we're gonna begin the revolutions that go around this section. So if you remember, this is the chart, and so we went from rows 1 through 5 and then repeated 2 through 5, so we ended up with the section just like you already have seen on your own project. Now we're gonna go from rows or rounds number 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and we're going to go in a continuous revolution now from this point forward even into clue number 4. It's gonna be a continuous revolution. So as we start, we're going to be on the one corner where we have not fastened off on the bottom edge, and just consider this as the start of the bottom edge just so that you're aware of that. And we're going to chain up one, and we're going to put 3 single crochets into the first one, and we're going to single crochet ourselves across the top edge, and that includes into this chain one spaces. And then when we come down here, we're going to be on the side of the project, and when we look at the side here, this is the side that there's no stitch work in. It's right here until we hit the box okay, the big square that's in the front. So what we have to do is that we have to squeeze from the corner all the way to this point, 12 single crochets, and then we're just gonna pick up on this box and go all the way down until we hit the other side where this is on the other edge. Okay, so this back on the top edge and then back across. So that's how we're kind of looking at it. So we're gonna come down and we're gonna put 12 single crochets equally spaced, hit the box, and we're gonna go each single crochet. And when you visualize it from this point, the box will be up here. The box meaning the big square, and then you're gonna come and put 12 single crochets in and then hit the corner and then go across and then come back up. So that's what we're gonna be doing now, and we're going to begin changing our colors then in row number 5. The final color is the accent color, and in my case it's been the vintage white as I've been going across as my accent. So let's begin round number 1 and let's start. So let's begin. Remember that you should be looking at the right side of the project, which is right here, and I keep calling it front, but it's considered the right side, and just so that you're aware, so that if you are seeing the wrong side as you're going up this side and you're going across, then you know it's a problem. So make sure that when you look down, it is the right side. It's really important. So let's begin. We're going to chain up 1, and in the top single crochet, the first single crochet that you had, you were going to put in 3 single crochets into that space or into that stitch. So 1, 2, 3. So it's kinda like the corner already, right? So the next one is a chain 1 space, so just go in there, and then the next one single crochet. So I want you just to single crochet in everything going across, so whether it's a chain 1 space or a single crochet, and meet me at the next corner in just a moment. So I've now just come across the bottom edge, and I'm hitting I got another chain 1 space first, and then I got the next single crochet, which is the last one. So in the last one, it's because it's a corner, I'm gonna apply 3 single crochets into that one. So 1, 2, and 3. So now our goal is to get 12 single crochets from this point to the start of this box. So it's just a matter of equally spacing them out. So what I do is I mentally visualize halfway point as being 6. So I'm gonna try to squeeze in 6 to around the halfway point, and then the other 6 to the other point. Sometimes you get it right the first time, other times you don't. You just gotta equally space. So I'm gonna try it here live. So 1, and I just wanna go into some chain work on the outside. I try not to go into massive gaps, because it gets really quite obvious that it's there. You just gotta take your time and just get your stitches in. So this is 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, so that's about the halfway point, and now I gotta get another 6 in there. So I just continue to count, make sure I don't get it wrong. So then 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. So now I physically have 12 stitches that are in that between the corner never counts. So I got 12 in there, and now I'm gonna jump right into the next empty white one here. Okay, the white stitch on the actual big square, and I'm just gonna continue to single crochet into each one of those stitches, then going to the other side where I'll run back into, so I'm just gonna come down and back around, I'll run back into here, and I'll put in another 12 spacing in there, and then I will, spacing means 12 single crochets in that area, and then I'm gonna turn a corner once again. So I'll see you there in just a moment. So I've been going down the side edge just like so, and I'm about to run out of the white vintage white area, and then I'm gonna hit the side of this here, and this is going toward, this is the top edge going up. So just like I did before, I need to space 12 single crochets between here and the corner. Okay, so let's try and do this one. So we're just gonna try to equally space. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, so I'm at around the halfway point, and I'm gonna squeeze another 6 in. So I'm gonna go 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. and I've just run out of yarn, so 11, and I'm just gonna join up a new one here. So I'm just gonna join a new piece of yarn here. So this was 11, so I'm just gonna use the new strand and pull it through. And I just gotta put in one more stitch to make my 12. So I'm just gonna leave that straggler down on top and bury it underneath. So now that I got my 12 in here from here to here, I'm now ready for the corner, which is the top of the single crochet. So that's gonna be a total of 3 single crochets in there, and I'm just burying over top of that straggler. So 1, 2, 3. So now we're gonna go along this edge here, and it's just like before, it's got chain one spaces, it's got single crochets. So we're gonna start off, and the first one is going to be a chain one space. So I'm just looking for it, see where my finger's popping through. So that's the first one. So just one single crochet into there, and the next one is a single crochet, continuing to bury over top of those stragglers. Do you notice I'm not freaking out because I'm having to do that? It's not a big deal. This yarn is really easy to hide. It's really quite a great product to work with. So just single crochet yourself across. This is the top edge as we go. So I've now just come across the top edge, and I'm working my way all the way to the corner. So the last one is a single crochet, and so then that one will be 3 single crochets into that one. So 1, and that allows me to turn a corner, 2, and 3. And guess what's next? I bet you know. So now we have to squeeze another 12 between this point and before we hit the white area here of the main square. So let's try to get in 12. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Try, and then another. So 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. I've been crocheting a long time, so I can pretty much get it right the first time. So that's 12 in there, and now I hit the first one that's empty, which is in the square, and I just single crochet myself. So I'm now heading back to the side that I have started on, and we're gonna hit that spot before the stitch. So if I just follow it all the way up, we're gonna hit that area, okay, right here, get in another 12, and then I'm gonna join it. So I'm gonna leave this for you, see if you can figure that out, and then I'll see you back here where we'll join. Okay, now that I have my section in, so I've come across, I did this on my own, okay, that you have your 12, and then once you get your 12 in, you just need to join it to the beginning single crochet that you started with right over here. So just stick in your hook and do a slip stitch like so, and now you're ready to go for round number 2. In round number 2, we've done a join at the slip stitch, and what we have to do is that we have to then slip stitch when we start the next round, and go to the middle one of the 3, and then start from there, chain up 1, single crochet in, chain 1, and single crochet into the same one. So just like we had done before where you had skipped over stitches, we're gonna be doing the same thing over here as well. So we're going to just have to watch this ones that are right in the middle, and so we single crochet, chain 1, and go right directly to the next one. So what I want you to visualize is that there's 3 in a row. So let me just show you over here. So there's 3 in a row, okay? So single crochet is in the first one, chain 1, the middle one gets 2 with the chain 1 that separates it, chain 1, and then 1 right in the end. So if you can just visualize how to do that there, it's a lot easier. Let's move along to round number 2. So let's begin round number 2. So there's 3 single crochets in there. We've joined to the first one. So we need to single crochet over 1 over, and that's the middle one of the 3, just like that. So now we're in the middle. So we're gonna chain up 1, and we're gonna single crochet into that same spot that we just did that last slip stitch to, chain 1, and then single crochet back into that same spot again. So there you go. So we're gonna chain 1, and just come to the very next single crochet, which is part of that corner, chain 1, skip 1, and 1 single crochet into the next. So chain 1, skip 1, 1 single crochet in the next, and you're gonna do that until you hit the next corner where I've already explained how the corner looks, but I'm gonna review it one more time with you as I turn the first corner, and then I'll leave the rest of this round for you to do. Ok, Okay, as I hit the next corner, I'm gonna chain one and skip one, and I'm in the beginning one of the three. So there's three in the corner, remember? So I'm keeping in count and it's matching up perfectly, which is good. So you're gonna chain one and go to the middle one. So this one is the one, okay? So chain one, so next one is the middle. Then you chain one and go back into the same one because you're in the middle. Chain one and just go directly to the next one. Okay, that's your three in the corner. And then chain one, skip one, and begin again all the way down the edge. So please do all the remaining corners like that, and I'll see you at the end of this revolution where I'll show you how to fasten off, or sorry, how to finish off this round, and then we'll move on to the next. So as I come back around, single crochet, chain one, and then I'm just going to just join it to the very first one that we had, okay? So the first single crochet in, just like that, and then that finishes off that round. There you go. So let's move on. I'm gonna take you back to the chart and let's review number three. So let's review number three. Number three is the puff stitching all over again. So what we're going to do with this is that we're going to slip stitch over and we're gonna get to the middle one, okay, of these here. Okay, so it's in between, just like this. We're gonna chain up two and then we're gonna puff stitch in just like that. Chain one, puff stitch into the same one, chain one, and then move up and put in puff stitch and chain one in between every one of the chain one spaces, just like this. What are you gonna do in the corner? Corners are all gonna be the same. It's gonna be puff stitch in, chain one, and puff stitch into the same one when you go to do the corners, just like that. Let's review on how to do this. So let's begin number three. So we've joined on, okay, right where the first single crochet was, and here is where the, see the two are coming into one, just like there, and there's a chain one that separates them. I want you to slip stitch into the chain one, and that'll put you right to where you need to be. You're going to chain two, doesn't count as anything, it's more of a builder than anything. Coming into the same space, I want you to puff. So you already know how to do that if you've been following along in these tutorial series. So you're gonna do a puff, followed by a chain one. Coming into the same spot, you're gonna do another puff. So the corners are always gonna have two puffs with a chain one that separates them, like so. So just take your time, just kind of, you know, there's no rush. Chain one, and then you're just gonna come in between all the chain one spaces that you see. So here's the first one right here. So it's just right there, so we're gonna puff. Just like that, chain one. Okay, there's the next chain one space right there. So the single crochet, there's a chain one, and just continue to do that. So I'm gonna leave the entire round for you to do on your own. So remember for the corners, as I drop my stitch here, remember for the corners, there's two puffs that separate, are separated with a chain one, and that'll allow you to turn the corners perfectly to keep your afghan sitting balanced and also sitting flat. So just remember to do that on your corners and filling in all the other chain one spaces with just a one puff each. I think I'm getting more tense or something. It's crazy stuff. So I'm just gonna pull through and then chain one. So again, your tension has everything to do with your success. So I think I need to relax and probably put on a pot of coffee. Okay, we'll talk to you soon and I'll see you at the end of this round. So I'm coming up all the way back around. Here is the corner where I started, where there was two into the same one. And this round of all the rounds for the remainder of the afghan is probably the longest that it will ever take you. It's the only time the puff appears all the way around. So I know it's slow, but you know what? You have to have these beautiful stitches in order to really make that pop. So once you get the last puff in, all you just need to do is just slip stitch it to the top of the first puff that you began with, just like that. Okay, so you ignore that chain two and just go right for the top of the puff. Let's begin to do round number four. So back to number four. So all we're gonna do now is that we're just gonna concentrate on doing what we did before with single crochets and chain ones. In the corners, there will be just one single crochet, chain one, one single crochet. That's in between the two puffs that are in the corner. And then we're just gonna go all the way around. This will be the last time you're gonna be using this particular color because the fifth round is gonna be the accent color, which finalizes clue number three. Let's begin to do round number four. just before I take you to round number four, you're gonna notice that there's two dots. So when we go to start up round number four, we're going to do a slip stitch over to this chain one space, and then chain one from there and single crochet in, chain one, single crochet in the same one. So right now we're on top of the first puff, so we just gotta move over one. So that's what we're gonna do first. So let's begin to do round number four. So we're just on top of the first puff. Let's just go into between the two, which are in the corner, and we're just going to slip stitch and then begin from there. So we're going to chain one, single crochet in there, chain one, and single crochet back into that same spot. So now the remaining of this side all the way to the next corner will be chain one, okay, and you go in between the puffs like we did down here. Do you remember doing that down there? We're gonna do the exact same thing as we go along the outside edges. So remember in the corners, in between the two puffs that are in the corner, you're gonna put a single crochet, chain one, single crochet, and then continue to move around. So make sure you please do that for this one. And when we get back all the way around, we're going to fasten off, and we'll do the fifth round together, which is the accent color, and concludes clue number three. So I'm coming all the way back around, and I have the two single crochets in the very corner, and I'm just maintaining the stitch counts that are already there. So now that I'm all the way back around, I've just gotta join it to the beginning single crochet just like that to maintain. So this color is officially done for me. I'm going to fasten off, and I'm going to bring back my vintage white accent color in order to do the final revolution, which is single crochets all the way around except for the corners. We're gonna do three single crochets. So fasten this off. I'm just weaving these in and out because I know the single crochet when I go around is going to trap this in a position really quite nicely, and you'll really never see where I stopped and started. So now I'm ready to begin the final revolution of number five. So if we look at number five, all we're just gonna do at this point is that we're just gonna put single crochets all the way around except for the very corners. We wanna put three into there. So when I fasten on, I'm gonna fasten on in between the two single crochets in round number four that are in the corner. So let's begin to do that next. So starting on the corner, I'm just gonna create a slip knot to begin, insert my hook, and just look for the one that is right in the corner. See how these two are going to the corner? So that's the corner. And I'm just going to slip this on. So just gonna join it with a slip stitch like that, chain one, and then I need to put three single crochets into the same spot. So one, two, and three. So all I'm just gonna do is that I'm gonna move around. So the next one is just a single crochet into the single crochet. The next one is a chain one space. So the chain one space is gonna get one single crochet. So it's kinda like what we've done before, right? So every single crochet is gonna get a single crochet, and every chain one space is going to get a single crochet. And in the corners, we're going to just put in three single crochets right in that corner. So please do that all the way around. I'm gonna leave that in your hands, and I'll see you at the end of this revolution where we'll fasten off together, and that'll conclude clue number three. So I'm coming up to the conclusion of clue number three. It's the final revolution, number five. And this has been pretty good, and it's looking really good. I really like the color selections that I've made for my particular example as well. And everything's working out a-okay. So once we get close to the corner, we're going to do a slip stitch and join it to the very top of the first single crochet that we started with to bring that to conclusion. So there's the chain one space. There we go, and it's the last single crochet. There you go, and then we just join it to the beginning single crochet. So that's it. So I want you to fasten off, weave in your ends, and you can join me then next Monday as we do clue number four. And again, as I promised, clue number four is really no big deal, and it goes really quickly too. A lot quicker than clue number three, but most of the hard work has already been done. So you're ready to go, and let's see you back here next week. So that's it for now. You got some homework to do. Better get it done, because clue number four is a cinch. It really truly is. So you get this done, you are laughing because clue number four is so easy. It's not even funny. No, seriously, it's not. Just between us friends, right? So you're going to join us then next week to conclude week number four. Your Afghan, it's gonna be ready for gift giving by the end of it. And of course, you can join us on our Facebook events page on Joanne's Facebook in order to share your work in progress and any ideas that you may have. And you will probably be inspired by others' creativity at the same time. So on behalf of Joanne.com, I'm Mikey of the Crochet Crowd. Thank you so much for joining me for week number three. And we'll see you for the final clue next Monday. And join us right back, right here.